Hello friends, Amy R here with Prairie Paper and Ink, playing with distress spray stains today, and one oxide spray. I'm kind of going between both of them, and just, if you've been watching my recent videos, I'm kind of loving the sprays. So, for today's cards, I started with some distress mixed media heavy stock. You could also use like distress watercolor paper, the white heavy stock. Anything that can hold up to a lot of liquid, really. So I started with that, have it in my splat box, a piece of paper towel, because I was also watching Tim Holt's most recent live video. He has them all on replay on his channel. Highly recommend. Because one, tons of inspiration, and two, tons of product info if you are not familiar with... There's so many products. I can't even begin. So I had that kind of going in the background while I was doing this. And the one thing he did was he had a piece of paper towel in his splat box when working with sprays. And I was like, and I've known this and I always forget about it, but it helps to absorb some of the excess so that the, you know, whatever, whether you're using a splat box or a cardboard box or whatever you're using, it helps absorb the excess so that you don't have like pools of liquid, you know? So I worked in layers and I'm just playing. I was in a very green mood. It's been snowing here. We're having second winter again, which is very common in Saskatchewan. We'll get snow right into April usually. So I wanted to do green. So I was literally just experimenting. I'll link to the specific colors, but for spray stains, I was using Rustic Wilderness, Crushed Olive, Twisted Citron, and Speckled Egg. And then I also brought in a bit of Speckled Egg Distress Oxide Spray. So, completely different medium in a sense. And it just gives it an interesting look. It kind of softens it, because with this one, I kind of sprayed it after. And then with the background I do next, I spray it first. Like I said, experiment. You know, I've had a lot of comments from people about... they don't have sprays. They want to try these techniques with their, you know, distress ink pads, etc. Go for it. You know, the splattery, smooshy looks and all that kind of stuff. Totally. You know, you're going to get different looks with either one. But the whole point is to just experiment with what you've got. Have fun with it. I'm really loving the sprays. And I'm glad I'm using them more because, you know, I bought all the oxide sprays. And now I'm slowly getting all of the distress spray stains because I was never big in the sprays. Anyone who knows me, I've got to have them all. I've got to have all the colors in all the mediums. But now I'm actually using them and I'm having so much fun. I think why I like the sprays so much is they're very unpredictable in a sense. Like even these two backgrounds, they're completely different. Same colors, same paper, you know, same method, but they still end up completely different. And it's just fun. It's fun to experiment. It's fun to see what's going to happen. I had a vague idea of what I was going to do with this card, but the backgrounds themselves, they just take on a life of their own and I'm really enjoying it. So there will be more videos. People have been saying they've been enjoying them and I'm really glad you guys are, and I'll have more coming. Like I'm enjoying this. So I was using my heat tool to kind of speed up the drying process with everything. And then why I chose greens and, like, you know, just doing these green backgrounds is I was going to die cut them. And I have this little Trinity Stamps. This is actually the Autumn Rainbow set. I bought this last fall. Yeah, this came out like late last summer, something. I remember buying it and that everything was crazy, you know, shipping and just everything's still nuts. Everything's nuts. But I'd purchased it and then I never got a chance to use it. So I'm using it now for a spring theme, although I'm not in a fall mood right now, but the colors, like to do like a, you know, splattery backgrounds in fall colors, like reds and rusty hinge and, I'll get to it. I'll get to it. But for now, I really wanted to do just green and spring and all that stuff. So I lined up the coordinating wafer dies just to kind of give me a rough idea of where, you know, where I want to stamp things. And then I lined up the coordinating little stamps, and they're the stamps in the set are just the veins of the leaves, which I think is so much fun. And I'd use my anti-static powder tool. However, these backgrounds were heavily saturated, so they're not dry, like fully. And I didn't test it. And honestly, in the end, I'm not worried about it. But I stamped the images with Rustic Wilderness Distress Oxide ink. And then I'm using the Rustic Wilderness Distress Glaze. And I'm glad I chose this combo. I had originally planned to just stamp it with clear embossing ink and then heat emboss them with white embossing powder. And because these backgrounds weren't fully dry, like the white embossing powder wouldn't have looked as nice because like there's speckles all over these backgrounds from the embossing powder. But I went with it. It's another thing I've been trying to just embrace more. Things don't need to be perfect. And this is completely different than like stamping a sentiment on black cardstock that you're heat embossing in white. Obviously, you don't want like speckles all over the place so you can't read it. But with this, it just, the speckles of that Rustic Wilderness Distress Glaze just kind of added to it. And I just went with it and it was fun. So after I heat embossed these, I used the coordinating wafer dies. And off camera, I did the same thing with the second piece. And then I also stamped, like I used all these pieces. Like I stamped several of the other leaves separately and then heat embossed them as well and die cut them. So I use up, you know, all my little bits and pieces. So I have this little pile of these leaves here. So after those were all die cut, I die cut some white cardstock. And it's really hard to show. You can kind of see it there when I showed it close up. This is one of the modern embossed rectangle stacks. I used this in a video a while ago, but I love them because they just basic rectangles, but they also emboss close to the cut edge, just a nice line. And it just gives it, you know, that little extra something that I love. So I did that. And then I also am going to use the A2 Foundations rectangle stencil set. This set has 4 stencils in various sizes of rectangles. And then it also includes the rectangles, so you can use them either as a stencil or a mask, depending on what you're doing. And there's different shapes not available. I used the heart ones back in, what was that, January, whenever. And I like them. So before I actually get to the stenciling, though, I just kind of use that as a visual. And I stamped a little sentiment from this set, which I love. And same thing. I use my anti-static powder tool. I stamped the sentiment with that Rustic Wilderness Distress Oxide ink. And then I coated it with the Rustic Wilderness embossing powder. You could just use clear embossing powder. I've shown that a ton of times, just stamping things with Distress Oxide inks, clear embossing powder. But if you have the coordinating glazes, the Distress Glaze embossing powders, it just gives it that little extra something. And especially with the new colors I have, because I get the whole like little collection kit, because it's like, why not? Again, all the colors in all the mediums. Anyway. So heat embossed the sentiment first. And then I lined up my little background here on the stencil. And these stencils have etch lines, all multiple etch lines, so that everything can line up. So I just flipped everything over and I just lined up my rectangle with the emboss lines on the stencil. And then that way that kind of just masks off a little bit of a perimeter. And then I'm going to do some very simple ink blending, and I'm going to use crushed olive distress ink and speckled egg distress ink. Again, just experimenting. Speckled egg is one of those colors, like I've loved it since it came out. But it's one of those ones that you just, when you start playing with it and mixing it with other colors, you just get some interesting results. Like that's why I was using it with the sprays and everything, because when it mixes with greens and, you know, if you mix it with pinks, you get, you know, pretty purples. I don't know. Speckled egg is just, I love it. Love it. I say that about every color. But anyway, blended these on just using some blender brushes. Just simple blending, nothing too crazy. Then removed the stencil. And then I've got that perfect, you know, masked off perimeter, which I love. I need to do this more. I say that about everything. But yeah, I have all these stencil sets from multiple companies. You know, there's circles and ovals and these rectangles, square. There's all the shapes, you know. And it's such an easy way to add, you know, color, dimension, etc. without having to add actual layers. So after I did the stenciling, I grabbed just some hemp twine from my stash, wrapped that around the card front a couple times, and then, like I have shown in a ton of videos, I just hold the knot closed with my reverse tweezers, and then that way I can build my bow without having to try and hold everything taut, you know, and give myself a finger cramp. So got that tied and then fiddled with it, removed the tweezers, fiddle with it a little bit more, and then trim off the excess. So I've got my little bow, and just get, again, it just gives it that little extra something. So once I've got that in place, I'm going to put my foam tape on the back, and I'm just using Simon Says Stamps Big Mama foam tape, which is actually very thin foam tape. It's only like, I think, a 16th of an inch thick, something like that. It's thin foam tape. I've raved about this in like a million videos. I love this stuff. So put this along the back of my card front. Once I've got that in place, I'm going to peel off the backing, and then I'll pop this onto my card base, which is a top folding A2 card made from Nina Desert Storm cardstock. So once I've got the card front applied to the card base, then I'm going to start arranging my leaf clusters. I had this rough idea from the get-go of how, you know, I was going to do this. So I sat and fiddled and kind of just like created this cluster with all of these leaves. And again, like, I did greens, but to do these fall colors, it would just love. It will look so beautiful. There's just something about fall colors, but I couldn't do it today. I needed green. I needed green and spring and hope. So once I had my cluster arranged and I was happy with it, another technique I've shown many times, press and seal. Gotta have a roll of this in your craft room. You need to have it in your life. It comes in handy for so many things, but I keep a roll specifically in my craft room. I keep this piece. I use the same piece over and over. I've had this roll for so many years in here. It's ridiculous because I'll keep using the same piece over and over again until you can't use it anymore. And I've shown it in videos. I use it to seal all my jars of pastes, that sort of thing. It keeps them from drying out. Like, it is a must have. So I use that to press into the cluster. It holds everything in place so that I could flip it over. And then I just put pieces of that foam tape all along the back, which holds down almost everything. And then once I've got the foam tape in place, I can peel off the backing. And then I basically just use the press and seal as a handle to rearrange, like replace it, you know, center it, etc., onto my card front. And then I just press it down. And then that one little leaf that wasn't fully adhered, I just used a little bit of craft tack glue, press that into place, and done. Love. So added a couple more leaves to the bottom corner, and then I'm going to add the remainder of the leaves to the inside of the card, because you can't leave the inside blank. It needs a little something. So I just added what was left of those leaves onto the inside of the card. And then, of course, I'm going to add a bit of splatter. Sprays weren't enough. I need more. So I just grabbed my Gonzai Tombi Starry Colors, aka just the gold watercolor, the same one that I use for all my gold splatter pretty much all the time. Sprayed a bit of water in there, worked it up really, really well with my brush, and then splattered this liberally all over everything, and then let that dry completely. And then it's just a final little bit of embellishment. I just added these confetti pieces. I don't have a link for them, but they're just kind of champagne colored. These are the Seashore Confetti Mix by Trinity Stamps. I don't even know if they're available anymore, but just kind of goldish. Some are kind of clear, some are just, yeah, they just give it a little extra something. So I just adhered several of them onto this card front with my craft tacky glue. Once those are adhered, I'm just going to pair this with a green envelope, again, just from my stash, and this card is complete. So as always, I will have a link below the video to my blog post. In my blog post, I'll have the pictures posted. I will have picture links to all the supplies used. You can check that out in the description box below the video if you are interested. Thank you all so much for watching, for subscribing, thumbs upping, commenting, all of it. I very, very much appreciate it. And yeah, if you aren't already subscribed to Tim Holtz videos, go on over there, check them out. They're just tons of info, just tons. Tons and tons of info and inspiration. Worth it. Worth every second. So, anywho, I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.